Arpit, so you might be aware that you're one of the most respected persons at Capital City Toastmasters. You have won several speech contests, held several leadership positions. Arpit, do you honestly think that you deserve this much respect?
I don't.
Hello everyone and welcome to the first episode of the CCT Talk Show Season 2. And your host Ananya is blessed to have a very special guest. Well, he's an engineer, but that doesn't make him special. But let me continue. He's a computer science engineer from DTU, currently working as a manager at Paytm. He's also serving as an area E3 director, District 41 of Toastmasters International. He's a founder of a speaking platform, SpeakingPad, and he's also a noob investor. Arpit, tell me honestly, how much did you gain since lockdown?
I think I have gained around 5 kgs, if I have to be honest on this. Yes.
That was a well-crafted answer, Arpit. So I'll explain you the format of this talk show. So this talk show will be divided into 3 parts. The first session would be a general question answer session. The second session would be a table topic or an impromptu speaking session, which I'll explain it at that point of time. And the third session would be a rapid fire where I'll ask you 6 questions and you need to answer instantly. Okay, so Arpit, perfect then. How has been your experience as an area director at Toastmasters so far?
Okay. First of all, good evening or good morning or good afternoon to all our audience members. My experience as an area director has been good so far, I would say. But, COVID has played a little bit of spoilsport because we don't get to see all those club members, not only from CCT but also from other clubs. So I was looking forward to meet them, but this lockdown has got extended like forever now. So this is the only spoilsport part. But apart from that, the experience has been good. Earlier, the experience was limited to my home club only, that is Capital City Toastmasters. But now I get to interact with different president, vice president education, club EC members from different clubs. So it's a good experience, and I believe that anyone in Toastmasters who is looking forward to enhance their speaking as well as leadership journey, they should definitely have an eye on this post.
Amazing, Arpit. So I just had this question. Are you planning to contest for division director of Division E next term?
So I have given it a thought. So right now I would give my journey a sabbatical of 1 year. I'll take a sabbatical of 1 year from Toastmasters as far as leadership part is concerned. So yeah, I'll not be contesting this time for the division.
Okay, so Rishabh Agarwal, if you are hearing this podcast, your position is safe for the next term as well. Arpit, so as you might be aware that you are one of the most respected persons at Capital City Toastmasters. You have won several speech contests, held several leadership positions. Arpit, do you honestly think that you deserve this much respect?
I don't deserve that. Apparently, when I was the president of the club, people used to give me respect a lot more than I actually deserved. So it was kind of surreal that people are giving you so much respect. People are just leaving the chair for you just for you to sit on it. Something like that is something that I have never experienced in my life. So I believe that, yes, definitely I would say that kaafi zyada izzat milti. Yeah.
Thank you for answering that question, Arpit. I guess it was quite difficult to answer. Okay, so lately I've been following you on social media and I see that you have been posting a lot of stuff related to the need to learn public speaking, invest in stocks and exercising. Why do you feel that these three things are important?
Mm-hmm. Right. So I'll start from fitness. So I believe that I read a quote somewhere from, I guess, Arnold Schwarzenegger, who I am completely obsessed about. So he's one of the people, or he's one of the persons I completely look up to as far as his fitness regime is concerned, or as far as his life philosophy is concerned. So I am someone who consider fitness very important in my life, because you have got one body, and if you're not taking care of it, with every sort of diseases coming in and people getting obese before lifetime, before they turn 40 or 30, and life expectancy is getting down. So, you know, you should, I'm not giving a very good answer on this, but yes, definitely, you know, taking care of your body is something that everyone should be having on their priority list. Second, stock market investing. So investing is something that I have been doing for the last 6 years now. So when I was in second year of my college, I started looking, you know, things apart from my college curriculum, and investing is something that completely, I would say, amazed me. So from then onwards, I started exploring about what are the different investment options available to people, because I believe in this difficult economic situation, it is very important to have multiple sources of income. So that is something that really amazes me. And third is public speaking. So public speaking is something that has completely transformed my life personally. So it's like, I was not like this 6 years back. So if somebody from my school is watching this interview or is listening to our conversation right now, they would be completely amazed, and they would not be able to recognize who this person is who is speaking right now, because I was completely different person. I didn't have any social skills. I could not communicate properly with people. I used to be very shy. So I believe that if this thing has transformed my life, so I make it a point that whenever I can share something to people out there, whether Toastmaster or not, I make it a point that I do that. So this is my answer to this. Yeah,
really enjoyed that answer, Arpit. So coming to public speaking, if you are going to take a formal retirement from public speaking, what are you going to say in your last speech?
Okay, that this speech is better than the last 1,000 or 2,000 or 5,000 that I have given, but the next one is going to be better than this one.
Well, I see that you're not leaving public speaking in that case.
Yeah.
Really love that. So what do you love about the art of public speaking?
So the art of public speaking I absolutely love is that whatever is there in your head or heart, you can express it out in form of expressions. So basically, it's like acting. So many a times acting needs words, and sometimes it does not require words. So it's same with public speaking. You have something in your mind, you have something in your heart, and you can get on a stage, and doesn't matter what is the number of people sitting in the audience, right? You can just be open, and that time which you get as a public speaker is completely yours. Nobody is having their share of of that time from you. So you have complete authority over that time. So you can express, and you can be yourself, and you can share your knowledge with people. If you are a subject matter expert and you know something, you can share it to people out there. So this is something that I absolutely love about public speaking, that it gives you an opportunity to speak out your mind, right? And at the time, you are the master of that stage. So it's like nobody can take you out from that position. So many a times people listen to you to speak, but as a public speaker, when you're speaking, you are given that chance to speak, and people generally listen to you. So that's the beauty of that particular thing. So, yeah,
I feel the same, Arpit. Rightly said, Arpit. And yeah, lastly, so this is the last question of this segment, is that if I'm not wrong, you are a part of Toastmasters International for nearly 2.5 years. So I just had this question: what motivates you to renew your Toastmasters membership every time?
So Toastmasters is known for two things: public speaking and leadership. So both the legs of my journey have been fantastic so far, and I believe that there is no stoppage to your learning process. So you have become a better speaker than you were, right? And I am a better speaker than I was 3 years back. So definitely, if I stop my journey right now, 6 months down the line, I might have to start from ground zero, right? So it's a continuous process. You should not be stopping that anytime soon. So this is my reason for renewal. But it's like going to the gym. You have developed a good, you know, physique by working out for 1 or 2 years. But if you just stop working out, within a span of 6 months or 1 year, you will again come back to the same level. So it's a continuous process. So that's why I'm renewing my membership for not only this term, but next term, next term, and many more terms to come, because it's a continuous process and there should not be any stoppage to that.
Wow, that was so lovely to hear from you, Arpit Gupta. Now I'll move on to the second segment of this talk show, that is a table topic session, which can also be called as the impromptu speaking session. Now, table topic session is one of the favorite sessions of every Toastmasters. In this session, a speaker is provided with a topic by a table topic master, and the speaker needs to speak immediately on that topic for 1 to 2 minutes. So it requires one to think on their feet, something which Arpit Gupta will demonstrate today. Point to be noted that Arpit Gupta has no idea of the topic which I am going to present to him. So Arpit, for your convenience, I'll be mentioning, like, if 1 minute elapses, I'll write it down on the chat box for your own convenience, and you need to speak for it at the most 2 minutes. Perfect. So your topic is real learning takes place outside the classroom.
Hello everybody, how are you doing? I have something in my hand right now, and it's a very special thing for all of you. Can you guess what it is? No? I have your attention right now. This is your attention right now. And the topic that I've got is absolutely beautiful, that real learning happens outside the classroom. And this is something that we have learned so vividly, so deeply in this lockdown. What do we learn in classroom? Maths, physics, chemistry, social sciences? But we do not use these kind of subjects, like chemistry and physics is something that we do not use as much as learning, investing, empathy, social skills, investing skills, and all of that. This is something that you can teach, that you can learn outside the classroom, right? For example, when you meet a new set of people in a party, you get along with those people, you learn social skills, right? If you are in a classroom atmosphere and you are just being taught whatever the teacher wants to teach to you, you get to learn only one aspect of it. But once you get out of your classroom, you get to learn social skills, you get to learn networking skills, you get to work on anything that you want to work upon, because you are not constrained by the classroom environment. You are out in the open, you can have real life experiences, and you can just push your boundaries, and you can just emerge victorious. So this is something that I have for all of you, that just don't have a very rigid idea in your mind that you can learn only in a classroom environment. There are a lot of things that you can learn beyond the classroom, like empathy, social skills, networking skills, investing skills, and the list goes on and on. It's up to you to explore it. Thank you.
That is very well presented, Arpit. Let me tell you, I'm sure all our listeners and viewers are enthralled by this impromptu speech that you have presented, Arpit Gupta. So finally, we move on to the exciting segment and the last segment, that is the rapid fire segment. Arpit, are you ready to face questions?
Yes.
Okay. So your first question is, what is something that people often get wrong about you?
That I have anger problems.
What's something you have failed at?
Making some good decisions at some point of time in my life. That was a very diplomatic answer, I know.
Your celebrity crush?
Deepika Padukone to some extent.
Do you snore?
Yes, my mother says it.
What's your hidden talent?
I think I have published most of my talents out in the open, so I would not say I have any more talent to show to people out there.
Your last question, is there anything I should have asked but I didn't?
What is my relationship status?
Wow, Arpit, it was such a pleasure to talk with you, Arpit. Now, Arpit, any final thoughts on this talk show?
So this talk show revolves around Toastmasters and life in general. So I just want to say that thank you, Ananya, for taking this initiative. First of all, it would be beneficial for people who are looking to join a platform to improve their speaking skills primarily, and then leadership skills also. So that's a great initiative. If you are going to post this video on YouTube, I hope that this gets to as many people as possible so that they can get benefit out of it. And one thing is that if you are someone watching on this online, if you're thinking too much about how it's going to be in a Toastmasters kind of setting, how I'm going to improve my public speaking skills, I would just say that attend a meeting as a guest, and going forward you will learn more things. And it's a very simple concept, but simple things make you learn a lot of things in life. So I am sure that if you join Toastmasters, you're going to become a better version of yourself. So please join Toastmasters, and thank you again, Ananya, for having me here and taking this interview.
Rightly said, Arpit. So viewers and listeners who are watching this, if you have interest in learning what a Toastmasters club look like, feel free to connect with us, follow our Instagram and Facebook pages for latest updates. And I hope that we come up with more such interesting episodes. It was a pleasure having you, Arpit Gupta. And
I think I should ask people to like, share and subscribe.
Yeah, so this was the only, what do you call it, the scripted part of this interview, which I sent to Arpit before this talk show.
So if I had said it, Ananya would have killed me after the interview. So I am sharing this line with you, that please like, share and subscribe to our channel on Facebook and Instagram. We are known by the name of Capital City Toastmasters. Yay!
Thanks, Arpit, for doing so. And let's meet sometime soon, Arpit.
Thank you, Ananya.